Hey guys, how are you today? So today we're going to work on multiplication, and to do that we're going to use our flat bead frame. So today we're going to be multiplying with various digits in our multiplicand and two digits in our multiplier. To do this work, you've already worked with the large bead frame several times, and you've had practice also with the flat bead frame, because today what we're going to do is record our partial products as we work. Here you can see my multiplication is already set up on my paper. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to multiply by the units in our multiplier. We don't need the 3 in our tens place, because first we're going to start with the 4 in the units place. And we're always going to start with the units of our multiplicand. Ready? So we are going to take 8. 4 times, which gives us 32. Now we will take 4 tens 4 times, which gives us 16 tens. We're going to take 3 hundredths 4 times, which gives us 12 hundredths. And now we're going to take 2 thousandths 4 times, which gives us 8 thousandths. Okay, so I have finished multiplying by the units of our multiplier. We have 2 ones, 9 tens, 3 hundredths, and 9 thousandths. I'm going to write that down on my paper. It's my first partial product. So we have found our first partial product, 2,348 multiplied by 4 gives us 9,392. Now we need to multiply by the tens of our multiplier. So now that I have found my first partial product, I'm going to clear my bead frame. And I'm going to multiply by the tens of my multiplier. So I'm going to turn over my 4. And reveal my 3 tens. Now we're multiplying the tens, so that means I need to start with my tens over here as well. I'm going to push my multiplicand over one space, and look what I have, a red 0 in the units place. You've seen those red zeros before, haven't you, in the large bead frame, remember? Okay, so now we're going to start again with our units of the multiplicand, and we're going to multiply all of our multiplicand by 3 tens. So here we have 8 units multiplied by 3 tens, which gives us 24 tens. Now we have 4 tens multiplied by 3 tens, which gives us 12 hundredths. Remember, tens multiplied by tens gives us hundredths. We have 12. Now we have 3 hundredths multiplied by 3 tens, which gives us 9 thousandths. Remember, hundredths multiplied by tens gives us thousands. And look, now that I have 10 all together here, I must make an exchange. 10 thousands gives me 1 10,000. Now I have 2 thousands multiplied by 3 tens, and that gives me 6 ten thousandths. Thousands multiplied by tens gives us 10,000s. Okay, now I have finished multiplying by the tens of my multiplier and I have my second partial product. I have 0 units, 4 tens, 4 hundreds, 0 thousands, and 7 ten thousands. I'm going to write that down on my paper. So now I'm going to write down my second partial product. 0 units, 4 tens, 4 hundredths, 0 thousandths, and 7 ten thousandths. Now I have my two partial products. What am I going to do with those numbers? Remember, when we multiply, we have to add our partial products when we are finished. So I need to add my two partial products. So I'm going to put my addition symbol. And when we add numbers together, we always start in the units place. 2 plus 0 gives me 2. 9 plus 4 gives me 13. Carry over my 1. 3 plus 4 is 7 plus 1 is 8. 9 plus 0 is 9. And 0 plus 7 is 7. Let me add my commas. 2, 3, comma. So now I've added up my partial products, and I have my final product of my multiplication. 2,348 multiplied by 34 gives me a final product of 79,832. Now you guys can make your own multiplications using the flat bead frame. And if you don't have a bead frame at home, what you can do is using a cereal box, you can cut out the top and the center, making a rectangle space, and using thread tightened on the two ends of your empty space, you can put beads, and you can make your number tiles with paper, and you can practice on your own homemade flat bead frame. Okay, well, I hope you had a good time watching this presentation, and we'll be back for the next one. Bye!